Hello friends, sorry for delayed video. Hereafter I'll be working as soon as possible. Before getting into the topics, I'm very grateful for you all because I have reached 100 subscribers. I haven't included anyone from my personal side to get more subscribers from other fields other than literature. I used to take this on a flow. If it's useful, people may subscribe it. That was my idea. Whenever I rewatch my own videos, I find mistakes here and there. I'd be spelling or pronunciation mistakes. Thanks for tolerating all those mistakes. Please pardon me. I'll be working hard to create better content, I assure. I feel like handling a mass of class. When I post this video, there may be more than 100 subscribers. I am grateful for them too. Thanks for your trust. When I think of naming this channel, I have chosen Let's Learn Together because I'm open to learn as well. Everyone is a teacher here, must be graduates and students. Something you people know, I may not be aware of it. If I lack any material concern to our portion, I will ask for your help. Please get me those materials to make better content possible. And the question must be raised in your mind. This is TNTRB. Why don't she give notes in Tamil? Of course, I'm more comfortable in Tamil than English. But the reason behind is consistency of knowing our second language, and that future people from other languages can be useful through this. Once we get ourselves more in what we learn, the knowledge may unconsciously goes into our mind. It's a tip that I used to follow from my college days. As a literature student, we have the opportunity to try this. Thanks folks, let's learn together friends, and if I lack any materials, I'll be approaching you people. Thank you so much. Sorry for consuming more of your time. Today's topic is A Midsummer Night's Dream. It's written between 1595 to 96. It's a comedy and a play sets up in Athens. Critics believe that the play had been performed at an aristocratic wedding in the presence of Queen Elizabeth I. This play was written at the same period of Romeo and Juliet. It was printed at the first quarto edition, 1600. The main theme of the play is love and marriage, which confuses the situation with a happy ending. Characters of this play, I have disintegrated them into certain types for better understanding. Couples, Theseus and Hippolyta. Theseus, he is the Duke of Athens, and Hippolyta, she is the Queen of Amazon and she is engaged to Theseus. Hermia and Lysander. Hermia, she is the daughter of Aegis, and Lysander, he is in love with Hermia. Demetrius and Helena. Demetrius, he is a suitor of Hermia, and Helena, she is in love with Demetrius. And some of the other characters, Aegeus, he is the father of Hermia, and Philostrate, the master who reveals to Theseus. He is always there with Theseus. Fairies, they are supernatural characters. Oberon, he is the king of fairies, and Titania, she is the queen of fairies. And Robin Goodfellow, he is called as Puck. He is a problem-causing fairy throughout this play. And a clan of actors who likes to perform at the wedding of Theseus and Hippolyta. Peter Quince, he is a carpenter. Nick Bottom, a weaver. He is transformed into ass by Puck. Francis Flute, he is a bellows mender. Tom Stout, he is a tinker. And Snack, he is an artist who joins with them. He is a joiner. A joiner is the one who joined the woods. Joiner is a profession related to carpentering. Short summary of this play, confusion created during the marriage of Theseus and Hippolyta. Potion plays a main role in this confusion. And the confusion ends at their marriage. This is a short summary of this play. Act 1, Scene 1. Theseus and Hippolyta is preparing for a great feast to the city for their marriage. Aegis comes along with his daughter Hermia and her lover Lysander to complain against their love. He asks Theseus to grant the ancient right to marry his daughter as he wish or to kill her. This is an ancient Athenian rite. Theseus offered two options to Hermia. Either she should marry as per her father's wish or she should join nunnery. Meanwhile, Lysander plans to elope with her into the woods. Hermia agrees with him. Helena is fond of Demetrius, but Demetrius wants to marry Hermia. Hermia is in love with Lysander. When Lysander exposed this plan to Helena, that she would love Demetrius once they eloped, Helena tells this plan to Demetrius to make him love her. Scene 2. The troupe of artists led by Petrequins to perform a play Pyramus and Thisbe for the Duke's wedding. One of the members, Nick Bottom, is afraid to play as lion because it may threaten the ladies there. Finally, they plan to meet at woods outside the Athens to rehearse for their play, which is the same destination of elopement. Act 2, Scene 1. Robin Hood fellow, he is called as Puck, who meets a fairy of Queen Titania. He tells that it would be better when his master Oberyn and Titania didn't meet at all, because they used to quarrel whenever they meet. Fairy informs that her queen is visiting woods at night. After that, Oberyn and Titania meets and accuses each other about their infidelity and jealousy. Titania stole a young boy and taking care of him well, which jealous Oberyn. Oberyn wants to take revenge. He orders Puck to draw Pachu's pansies when Titania falls asleep, which makes her to fall in love with the first person she sees after she wakes up. To embarrass her, Oberyn wants Titania to see an animal and a hidden at wood to enjoy the scene. Demetrius and Helena arrives. He wants her to leave him alone as he cannot love her anyhow. Even she informs about Lysander and Hermia's elopement. Oberyn overhears the conversation and sends Puck to drop some potion on an Athenian man to make him fall in love with his real love. The Puck agrees and plans the situation. Scene 2. Titania dances with her fairies and fallen asleep. Oberyn is waiting for the chance and pours the pansy juice at her eyelids. Lysander and Hermia walks too long and they lost their way, and they are very tired and fallen asleep. Hermia asks Lysander to maintain distance as they are not married yet. Puck enters and looks at Lysander sleeping away from Hermia and thought he must be the man whom his master mentioned before. Puck drops a potion at Lysander's eyelids. Demetrius tries to avoid Helena and he leaves her alone. Helena sees Lysander sleeping and wakes him up. Lysander falls in love with Helena and starts to praise her beauty. When Helena leaves, Lysander goes behind her. Hermia wakes up and searches for Lysander. Act 3, Scene 1. The troupe of artists are discussing about the play. Bottom is afraid that he is playing the role of Pyramus, who commits suicide, which terrifies the ladies. They agree to write a prologue to inform that Bottom doesn't really kill himself, and they inform about Snake's role as the lion. When they rehearse at the stage, Puck eavesdrops their acting and they are committing mistakes on the performances. Puck put Ass's head on Bottom's head. Bottom is unaware about this and their troops are running away from him. Titania awakes and falls in love with Bottom's Ass's head and started to entertain him with her fairies. Scene 2. When Puck explains the situation to Oberon, he is overjoyed and inquires about the Athenian love. At the time, Demetrius and Hermia enters. Hermia accuses that Demetrius must have killed Lysander. She is very furious and left the place. Demetrius falls asleep. Oberon is very furious about Puck's confusion in plan. Helena believes that Lysander is mocking at her. When she wakes up, Demetrius, whose eyelids with the pansy juice, he has fallen in love with Helena. Both men fight about Helena, that who is loving her more. Hermia arrives and gets shocked by Lysander's words. Helena thinks that all the three are making fun of her, and she accuses Hermia for misusing her friendship. Hermia tries to separate their fight, but Lysander pulls her off. She leaves the place furiously. Piran and Robin steps in and he is furious and asks the Puck to separate them. He orders Puck to make the men fall in love with the correct pair. Puck makes the man asleep and rub the juice from Lysander's eyes to make him fall in love with Hermia back. Scene 3. Robin makes the pair asleep and make them love back with their correct pair. Act 4, Scene 1. Titania takes care of Bottom well. She asks the fairies to provide food whenever he wants. They fall asleep. Oppiran enters and asks the Puck to remove the juice from her eyelids. Titania wakes up in a dream of falling in love with an ass. She sees Oppiran and they plan to dance at Theseus' wedding. Theseus, Hippolyta and Eugeus arrive at boat with the hunting horns which makes the couple awake. Lysander confesses his love towards Hermia and Demetrius confesses his love with Helena. Theseus wants to override the rule of Aegeus' will and make them married along with his marriage at the same day. Bottom awakes at the word and thought that he was left alone and had a weird dream, and he says that he should make Peter Quince to write a poem, a ballad about his dream, which has been called by Bottom's dream. He thinks the happening of past is all a dream, not the reality. Scene 2. The troops are very disappointed that they cannot perform the play at Theseus' marriage, as he got married already. Bottom arrives with the happy news that they still have a time to perform the play Pyramus and Thisbe at the wedding. Act 5, Scene 1. Theseus and Hippolyta are at dinner entertainment. Aegeus listed the performance for them. Finally, the troupe comes with the title. A tedious brief scene of young Pyramus and his love Thisbe. Very tragical mirth. Aegeus tries to avoid it and Hippolyta calls it silly. But Theseus wants to watch it and calls it a very imaginative one. When Quince delivers the prologues, it reverses the meaning of the story and they play with the numerous linguistics errors. At the end, Bottom Flute gets up to deliver a epilogue, but they are supposed to lay a dead. Theseus asks them to dance and no need for epilogue. Scene 2, an epilogue. Puck enters with the broom and adds, "Not even mouse can disturb the lover, if so, he will protect them." Oppiran and Titania blesses Theseus and Hippolyta. They perform a fairy dance. Puck epilogues the audience by saying that if anything hurts the audience, they must imagine this as a dream and forget or forgive them. Thank you, friends. So far, we have seen A Midsummer Night's Dream. Next, we will be seeing Hamlet.